What's up, everybody, and welcome back to CountryCast. Today we have a lot of fun stuff to talk about. One conversation in particular: could there be a crossover into the country music scene by an artist that fans have been asking for quite some time? As well as some unfortunate events recently, we will be talking about a follow-up story surrounding the statement that Priscilla Presley gave about Elvis Presley's home, Graceland, after it was vandalized. Y'all know what to do. Stick around. And as always, just real quick before we get started today, I would like to remind everybody out there that our socials are now up and running. So head on over to Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter to give us a like and a follow. Our Facebook is CountryCast, our Instagram is CountryCast News, and our Twitter is at CountryCast News. Of course, if you are new here or if you've just been by the YouTube show before and haven't had the opportunity to hit that subscribe button down below, go ahead and do so, and don't forget to turn on those notifications so you don't miss out on any breaking updates on your favorite country artist, and of course all the news coming right out of Music City. So let's go ahead and get things started. Before we get to Priscilla Presley's comments surrounding the vandalism to Elvis Presley's home, Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee, I want to touch on something a little bit more lighthearted, a really good story, and it of course surrounds Blake Shelton. For all of you Blake Shelton fans out there, you know how good of a guy he truly is, and he's done it again. He turned to Twitter, where he is now giving some help to a Texas school teacher. This is what Blake Shelton had to say. First, he receives a tweet from the Twitter user that says, "At Blake Shelton, please, I teach at a low-income school in Texas. I have never had my list cleared. Could you at least share? It would mean everything to me. Hashtag clear the list. Texas loves you," with the link attached to it. Of course, Blake Shelton put a little bit of comedy in there, but he did exactly what all of us knew he would do, and wrote back, "Oh hell, I've had a few drinks, I'll take care of it for you." And man, I gotta say, when he shared it, it started going off the chain. People were ordering items off of that list left and right, and truly is making a difference. You gotta know it, if you're a Blake Shelton fan, that guy is a wonderful human being, and he proves it time and time again. So just really cool stuff there. And if you guys want to check that out, head on over to Blake Shelton's Twitter, where you can find that tweet in which he shared, and you can put some effort in to help clearing that list. Now, we're going to go ahead and switch gears here for just a minute and go a little bit outside of the box, because we're going to go outside of the genre, but we're going to come back to the genre. We're going to be speaking about a guy that most of you may be familiar with, Post Malone. Post Malone, we know, is a fantastic musician. Now, the guy does hip hop right now, but I'm telling you, he's done rock, he's done metal, he's done country. He has been seen alongside Dwight Yoakam playing music. We've seen him hanging out with Luke Combs, Carrie Underwood. We've seen a little bit of Hank Williams from Post Malone. We've seen some Johnny Cash. Post Malone is really into country music. Hell, he even wore a Dolly Parton outfit, okay, with her face that was from head to toe all over this outfit. So Post Malone really has a deep down respect for country music. There have been a lot of questions by fans, you know, will you do a collaboration with Luke Combs? They'll tag Post Malone in their tweets. They've even started talking about it with Morgan Wallen. Now, I'm going to say I'm a fan for both of those. I would love to see Post Malone and Luke Combs, or Post Malone and Morgan Wallen, do a collaboration of some kind together. Now, Whiskey Riff recently posted an article talking about Post Malone's desire to do music alongside not only Toby Keith, but George Strait as well. Whiskey Riff notated in their article that Post Malone has made several comments on different occasions talking about how he would really love to do music with the King, George Strait. I really think that would be something special. If you have not checked out Post Malone on some of his YouTube videos where he does Bob Dylan, this guy is really a phenomenal artist, a musician, and he has a passion for country music. And I think that we would be very accepting of Post Malone if he made that crossover, just because of how much of the respect and how much of the, you know, influence Post Malone could possibly have with having that traditional country music background. Hell, Post Malone is from Texas. I'm sure the King was somewhat of an influence to him when he was growing up. We have heard of Post Malone being influenced by Johnny Cash, so this isn't a too far-fetched idea. So the question is how much longer are we potentially gonna have to wait for Post Malone to make that crossover into country music? A lot of the more traditional fans out there, you're probably shaking your head at this idea, not liking the fact that this is a possibility, but I want you to do one thing, and trust me on this, that if Post Malone truly came over to country and cut an album, I think it would be more traditional than maybe some of the folks that we currently have coming out of Nashville. This is definitely a topic that needs some discussion around it. So of course, CountryCast Nation, come through for me like you always do. Start commenting down below and let me know your thoughts about this. And let's share some ideas maybe of just what we could possibly see from Post Malone and country, or if it's just a bad idea. But I gotta tell you, I'm leaning more towards I want to see Post Malone come over and do some country music stuff. Now let's go ahead and jump into what Priscilla Presley had to say about the recent vandalism to Elvis Presley's home, Graceland, in Memphis, Tennessee. Most of you out there probably have heard the news about the vandalism to Graceland, but for those who have not, Graceland was vandalized by graffiti all along the rock wall that surrounds the exterior of the home. That wall is very, very special to a lot of people around the world, because that is where Elvis Presley fans come and pay their respects and write a special note to the King of Rock and Roll. There is tons of messages all through the wall, but now it has been vandalized with a ton of graffiti, vulgar graffiti, that the Presleys had to dispatch crews out there to clean this wall off. Here are some of the photos. You can see the vulgar language along the wall, and it just extends so far. And when Priscilla Presley had to put out a comment regarding this, it was just really, really tough to read. And especially when you think about what the Presleys have been through recently, with Lisa Marie losing her son, and now there is this, a historic landmark in music, and it has just been destroyed, especially a man who brought people together all over. From all over, Elvis Presley brought people together. And he even crossed genres, R&B, soul, rock and roll, country. I mean, I don't even understand why this was something that was targeted, but unfortunately it was. Here is what Priscilla Presley had to say. Concerning the graffiti at Graceland, I'm absolutely horrified that those in our own city disgrace the walls surrounding Graceland. I'm saddened by acts like this and appalled by this behavior. We were able to clean all the graffiti off thanks to our dedicated crew. The good news, obviously, the wall was able to come clean, and we do know from local news reports from Memphis that the police are investigating this vandalism, but just something really difficult to look at when you think about who Elvis Presley truly was as a person, and what he did not only for music, but off of the stage as well. And of course, you know, this is something the Presleys have to deal with at a time where it has been a bit of a bumpy road, and here we are now dealing with the King of Rock and Roll's home vandalized. But again, good news, it was able to be cleaned. Guys, that will be it for today's video. Make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Turn those notifications on for breaking updates on your favorite country artist and all the news coming right out of Music City. Y'all stay country.